We are on the sixth lecture of our master detail project. This is an overview of what has been done so far. The introduction, the model classes, the startup class, index razor page, teacher's razor page, and today we are going to cover the publications page, and after this, the seventh lecture will be the last lecture. This is the teacher's page that we did in the last tutorial. In this chapter, in this lecture, we saw that we created a table. This table had teacher, and for each teacher there was a publications link. When this link is clicked, a query string is created, teacher ID, for the email of this record. This query string is sent to a page of publications. This is the publications page that we will be writing now. On this page, our target is to have the name of the teacher here and here also. We will also have a table consisting of the publications of this teacher. There will also be a data entry form for storing a publication of a teacher. This is the target. And this publications is going to send us a query string. This query string will be read on this publications page. Let us see how that will be done. Reading a query string. This is the table that I was just talking about. There is a link, let us say, for publications. When this link is clicked, a GET request is sent to your publications page. The GET request has a query string parameter called teacher ID. So how do we read this teacher ID on this page? How do we read this? For this, we will have our backing class. In the backing class, we will have to create a property of the same name as this query string. Teacher ID, teacher ID. This property will be marked as bind property supports get equal to true. Supports get equal to true, why? Because this is a GET request, and ASP.NET Core will automatically bind the value of this parameter to this property, and whatever query string is sent, that query string will be saved into this one by ASP.NET Core. So this is a very simple process how we can store a query string, how we can read a query string from a request and get it in our backing class. Come to the Solution Explorer and come to the Pages folder and add a razor page called publications. This razor page will have two files, CSHTML file and a CS file. Let us complete the CS file today. This is the publications.cshtml.cs file. These are the using directives and this is the backing class. Our first task is to cache the DB context. ASP.NET Core provides this DB context through the constructor, and this context is stored as a teacher context here so that we can use it for database communication. After that, we have a bind property supports get equal to true. This property teacher ID, this will be used to store the query string, and the query string data will be available to our class through this property. After that, we have a bind property for publication. This property is used to save the posted data that will come from the data entry form on our publications page. You can have a closer look. This will be the publication form. This will be the data entry form. The data for this form, when this add is clicked, the data for this form will be available in this bind property for publication. This property. So these two properties are bind properties, and then we have another property for teacher. Let me first review the teacher model. This is the teacher model. On this we have email, we have name, and we have teacher info. These three or four properties we have already discussed earlier, but there is one more property that was present. Let us have a look at that. We have added a property iCollection publications to this teacher model. This publications is a collection of all the related data from the publications table for this teacher. So this is a collection, and this is a collection of all the publications of this teacher. This is the teacher. Now why do we have it here? On our publications page, we have to show the list of publications of the teacher. This is the details part. The topic of this topic is master detail project, and this is the details part. The list of all the publications of the teacher, his name, this will be available through this property. Now this property contains not only the teacher's data but also I collection for the publications. So I collection will give this, and the teacher's data, that will give me this. Next we have onGet method. This onGet method is called when the page is loaded, and in this we query for the teacher context.teachers.where email is equal to teacher ID. And after that we write dot include x goes to x dot publications. This ensures that the related publications data is also populated in the teacher's object. The I collection will be filled only because of this. If we do not include this part, then I collection will not be filled, because your related data can be huge data. So this is made optional for us. If we need it, then we can write dot include. If we do not need this data, then we should not write this. But in right now we will need this additional publications data, so we have written dot include publications also. So this is important. After that we have this on post for saving the data that is coming from the posted form. This is if not model state is valid, return await on get. What it does is that if there is a model state problem, then for example if name is not filled, this error will be shown, and the data already filled, that will be retained on this page. I will explain this. If model state has problems, for example this is a required property, if there is a problem, then what we will do is return await on get. See on get. On get, what we are doing is we are querying the teachers so that when the page is presented again back to the caller, this data is shown. This takes care of this data. And then there is a return page. This page takes care of this data also and of the data that was already submitted. So that is why we have written await on get. So on get causes the teachers to be filled, and also this ensures that the data that already came from the page is sent back as such. Then this part will add the publication, will save the publication, await, save changes async. If there is some problem with the publications, for example ISBN, we indexed it, in case it is not unique, in that case a DB update exception will occur, and we will add a model error to the publication.isbn part of the form. This form we will write in the razor page, and there we will have a span for the validation part. The ASP validation for public.isbn is written here, and this error will be added to this span. So if there is a data entry problem, then like this a message will be shown here, ISBN already exists. And this is remove from the publications and await on get. Again the same thing, this will ensure that the data already filled will be there already on the form, and the teacher's data will also be there because of this whole process. And lastly, if everything goes okay, then we say redirect to page so that the page is shown again, refreshed, and a new query. Since the publications page requires a teacher ID as a query string parameter, we are saying redirect to page new teacher ID. So this ensures that teacher ID is added as a query string parameter back, and the whole page for the same teacher is shown back. this teacher ID, I could have written like this. Equal to teacher ID. This is the name of the query string parameter, and this is the value. This is the value from where? From this one. So redirect to page back with the query string so that the new data is there, and for the teacher the whole page is recreated. So this is how it works, and in the next lecture I will complete the Razor page, the publications.cshtml file. Thank you.